right. I don't know if this is working. So, let's see here, guys. I'm going to test out my, just going to test out my website here and see if it's actually streaming. So I've never done this before, guys. So bear with me. Bear with me. If you're on there, I'll be watching. I'll be on there soon, guys. So just stay tight. All right. Let's see if we're working on here. Let's see if this is happening. All right. Testing. 1, 2, 3. Let's see. Give me some comments, guys, if you could see here. Let's see if we're working on here. All right. I think it's working. I think. So we're going to get to it. I think it's working now. Sorry for the technical stuff here. So got this blank hat and got these new markers I'm going to test out. I want to find a nice light color. Just thinking about doing something beachy. Let's see what we got here. Got this new equipment. Never used it before. So hopefully you guys don't mind the shakiness of all this craziness right now. Excuse me here, guys. All right, let's try to do this. So, I've never used these markers before. I have no idea how they're going to come out, but I figured why not give it a go, right? Everyone's stuck on lockdown. might as well try to have some fun with it, right? So these are acrylic markers, and this is a FlexFit hat. Some of you guys, it's on me. Excuse me. No, I'm not sick. I'm actually choking on chips. I made some chips for my kids before. We were outside having a little picnic. A little vegan cheese and chip picnic, and now it's coming back up in my throat. So let's see. So these are acrylic markers. They're fine tip. I think they're like, these are like 0.7 millimeters. They're pretty fine. And right now I'm sort of just improvising. We were just at the beach a little while ago. It was, or a little private beach, I should say, a little nook that people don't go to. We were definitely practicing some social distancing. And so I got the beach in my head right now. So I wonder if you guys do also. Get off there, little fuzz. Get off there, fuzz. I'm gonna open up my Facebook page, see if you guys are there's anyone that wants to message me. I'll try to keep that open while I'm doing this. I think that'll work. Let's find out. And for my patrons, my new Patreon page is up, and I have the chat thing all set up on there, so I'm kind of doing a little testing, a little technology test right now to see what's going on. I see, okay, we got some people on here. We got Dan Lipper. What's up, Dan? Justin Moore. Can I buy when you're done? Yeah, totally. But let me first make sure that I do something cool for you. Justin is asking if I live in the Asbury Park area. Yes, in the area. We actually just moved, since you're local, we actually moved close to Spring Lake Heights. Not the super fancy, bougie part of Spring Lake Heights, but, you know, a very humble, nice little spot. And we really love it so far. It's really close to the beach. For those of you guys watching, first of all, thank you. Thank you for bearing with me. Hope you guys are all safe. Hope you guys are staying at home. We are. I think it's on week two of our lockdown, but I kind of lost track today. It felt like it was maybe 3 weeks, but then my wife, Chelsea, reminded me that it was pretty much exactly 2 weeks, give or take, which is nuts. It definitely feels longer than that, although I haven't really minded the isolation part of it. For those of you guys that check out my newsletter, I kind of just wrote about that. I sort of like the isolation part. I'm pretty much an introvert. Well, an extroverted introvert. I love being around people and my family and my friends. But then I also really love my quiet time. My being locked in my art studio or with my family is pretty much my favorite thing to do, my favorite place to be. So let's see. One thing I'm noticing with these markers, I do love them, but it kind of just like kind of sucks right in there. So you have to kind of go over it a few times to get it to be opaque, which is pretty normal for paint markers when you're drawing on fabric, especially. Trying to watch the video while I'm drawing. So still getting used to this. I got new like adapters, tripod thing, and like a cool stand that lets me keep my iPhone positioned while I'm doing this. You would have thought I would have done that like a year ago or two or five, but no, just got around to it now. Because I just set up this Patreon page the other day, and I got to create content. I got to be a content creator. Yeah, I'm one of them now. So what I think I'm going to do is I think I'm just kind of going to draw faster, and then I can always go back in and reinforce all the lines later. But rather than going over all the lines right now, I'm just going to kind of let it flow a little bit. For anyone watching, I'm completely just sort of ad-libbing, is that a word? Improvising. I'm improvising right now, as if you can't tell. And let me move this phone back a little bit. Just totally improvising. No mistakes, just happy accidents, as Bob Ross used to say. So I have this broadcasting on my Patreon, and I also have it on my Facebook page, which is, I think, where you guys are probably watching it. I was going to put it on the Patreon only, but since my Patreon is like brand new, I wanted to give everyone else something to watch also. But in the future, once I get that page built up, I'm going to be doing live feeds like this more often for strictly my patrons. And then I'll always show glimpses and some photos and some little snippets to social media, of course. I'm not going to ignore the rest of you guys. So right now, I'm kind of wondering to myself if I should make this monochromatic, which is a fancy way of saying just kind of limited colors. So like just blue, like just line art, or if I should make it super colorful. If anyone's watching and you want to throw your comment down, I'll keep an eye on that. Let's see here. You guys still watching? So this is super trippy. I just like clicked the Facebook page to see what's going on, and it like has subtitles. That's wild. Pretty weird. So you would think being on lockdown, I'd be like super creative and have lots of time, but we also just moved into a new house, which has been really time consuming, like setting up my art studio, and my wife has me installing ceiling fans and doorknobs, things like that. So I really have not had much downtime to just create. Plus, I'm also like a part-time homeschool teacher, apparently, now. So if any parents are watching, you know what I'm talking about. It's kind of comical to pretend that your kids are going to listen to you. In like an instructor role, it's sort of funny. Other kids, yeah, other kids listen to me. They think it's cool that I teach them art. My kids, not so much. they just want to do it themselves, and they just want to do everything themselves. But that's cool, because ultimately, that's a parent's job, I guess, is to make your job obsolete and have them be little independent people. Just saw a little updated comment. I'm like multitasking right now, which I'm not that great at, but I was like drawing and looked over and saw Justin's comment. Yeah, Spring Lake's pretty awesome. It's a really beautiful town. It's one of the towns that I love surfing in. And yeah, we're not in like Spring Lake proper, which is, for anyone that doesn't live in the area, it's kind of like a super fancy town. We're not in that spot. Someday maybe, but not right now. But we're in a great, great little spot. We have a fireplace, which is cool. Haven't had a fireplace for a while. Been making use of that. So how are we looking here so far? Pretty cool. I think I'm going to throw in some other colors. If you guys do, you know, hats at home, you'll see how like this acrylic paint pens, depending on what brand you use, they really kind of like just absorb really fast. So I don't know how exciting it is to watch me paint over the same lines, but maybe you can like watch this in the background while you're doing something else. Just, you know, not all art is glamorous, you know. Sometimes the process is tedious, but for me, it's really therapeutic. I love just getting lost in the process. Got it. Okay, I'm turning around as I'm drawing, which is always kind of funny. Let's see here. So, Alicia. What's up, Alicia? One of our friends, our local friends that Alicia's kids and my kids go to school together. They own an amazing pizza place. Actually, two, I think, right? Poor boys. And I just drew my table. Oh, well. Special thanks to Kevin Rigby for the table, by the way. He was like, anyone want a table? I'm like, yep, right here, bud. Tony just joined us. We're a little delayed in turning around. Tony Cullinan. Good morning, Jay. Lockdown for a lazy Saturday morning here in Oz on the far south coast of New South Wales at Bega. Am I saying that wrong? Probably am. B-E-G-A? Bega? Biga. Biga. Probably more like that, right? Just playing along with the guitar. That's great, dude. I love hearing that. So there's a, I'm on this app called Get Vocal, G-E-T-V-O-K-L, and there's a link on there that lets you like join in on the screen, but I have no idea how to do that yet. If I could somehow figure that out, I would put your video on so you can play music for us at the same time, which is kind of funny that I don't have music on right now, you know? I'm going to put some kind of tunes on while I'm doing this. Let's see here. How about... All right. I'm going to put on whatever. Let's see. Oh, look at that. I had a tiger. That's pretty cool. Let's see what kind of music we've got here. Hang out with me, guys, and put some tunes on. Putting on some tunes. 90s rock anthems on Spotify. Can't go wrong with that, right? All right, I'm going to get off Eye of the Tiger for a second here. My kids were practicing their school chorus, and one of the songs is Eye of the Tiger. Tony, all right, he's correcting me. Thank you. Biga. The B is pronounced like a bumblebee. All right, cool. Biga. I have been to Australia. It's an amazing country. I went to, we did Sydney, and then we did the Goldie, did the Gold Coast. And where else did we go? Byron. We did, forgot already. Brisbane, maybe. We were on, was on a tour with Donovan Frankenreiter in, I want to say almost 10 years ago. And we did like a week in Australia all around, and we ended up at the Byron Blues Festival, which is like incredibly awesome. Just decided to turn the hat around because quite often, whether it's a hat or whether I'm painting a canvas, I'll paint upside down. And I honestly forget that it's upside down, because when I paint, I'm like turning it sideways, upside down. And to me, I don't know if other artists can relate to this, but it doesn't matter if it's upside down, sideways, or whatever. It still looks the same to me. I'm kind of, I don't really register all the time that it's upside down. So I have to remember to flip it around to show you what it looks like normally. So you kind of tell the vibe I'm going for here. Justin Moore says, I let myself drift out a little too far one day after heavy rain on the beach. Yeah, man, there you go. It's good to drift away. Quincy Mumford joining us. What an honor. What's up, Quincy? My boy Quincy is super talented. Not only a singer and a songwriter and a guitar player, but he can do all that on the Indo board, amongst many other things. For those of you just joining me, thank you. Maybe you guys can share the feed on your page or something. Let your friends know. I'd love to get a little group together. I started doing this particular hat a little bit ago, and I wanted to get some content out there to give you guys something to keep you busy at home. I know for a lot of people, it's trying being home. For me, I kind of like the isolation a little bit, but I know for a lot of people it's really hard, and I think it's good to have some sort of connection going, so I wanted to do my part. And I also just started a Patreon page because I've been told it's a good way to help kind of monetize your talent, and with the economy the way it is right now, artists, musicians, photographers, creative people, hustlers, freelancers in general need some help. So if you haven't checked it out yet, I would love your support, or at least your opinions, on my Patreon page. It's a new thing I just set up, patreon.com/jalders. Any little bit counts. I have tiers set up for $2, and I will be doing these sort of live feeds with not only painting hats, but I'm going to get canvases on there. I'm going to be doing a lot of cool stuff. And I'll be doing that on a regular basis. But since it's a new page, I didn't want to broadcast for just like a few people. So I figured I would do this first one with a lot of you guys on here. So I want to throw in some funky stuff here, I think. I'm feeling these water forms. And kind of break it up a little bit. Throw in some shapes. Just because, why not? Shapes are fun. So I think there's like a slight delay in the video, which is fine. But if you guys comment, I am looking back every so often to see what's up with everyone. If you guys can text message your friends that I'm doing this, I'd love more people on here. I guess it's good for me to have social interaction too, even though I'm all alone in my studio. It's actually really nice. I've been in full dad mode for a few weeks, which I love. But just having like quiet time is nice. Very nice. Even though I have Nirvana playing in the background. What do you guys think so far? It's getting there, right? I wonder if you guys can tell me what you're up to, how lockdown has been for you. I really hope you guys are taking the corona stuff seriously. It's really scary. We have a friend of ours that is recovering from it, we hope, and she's doing a lot better, so I'm really happy about that. But a lot of people are not that lucky. A lot of people are really suffering. There's a lot of people losing loved ones right now, and that's really scary. So I hope you're doing your part to get this thing behind us. I'm really sort of optimistic and hopeful that this will get medical technology going forward at a faster pace. It seems like a lot of countries are working together to get this go, you know, get this behind us, which is nice. So I like seeing the cooperation. I like seeing the borders and the nationalities relinquish and people realize that we're humans first and we are citizens second. I don't really care what country you're from, what race, what religion, what gender, what label you are of any sort. We're humans first, and I like when people cooperate. John Lynch just joined, according to my little chat thing right here. What's up, John? What's up, Lynch family? Love you guys. They own Iron Buddha in Westwood, New Jersey. Really amazing spot that I did some murals at, and they're doing, they're also doing live feeds every day, I've noticed, like meditations, yoga, fitness. Definitely check them out. Yo, John. Yes, I saw your message. Yes, things are going good here. We've been pretty good, actually. My kids are really good sports about everything. You know, it's great how adaptable kids are. I feel like the problems that people have with being alone is really way worse for most adults I talk to. Most of the kids are just totally content being home with playing with a cardboard box and going on Zoom to talk to their friends. Seems like the adults are the ones who can't sit still. At least the ones that I talk to, they're the ones having the hard time with this. It's understandable. A lot of stuff to worry about. Health, finances, loved ones. It's, you know, it's a scary time. This is where I do my free plug again. So just to let you guys know, in case you haven't noticed, I did start a Patreon page. I will be doing live feeds like this more often for my patrons only. But today I wanted to just show some love and do this for everyone. I feel like we all need to do our part to entertain and keep ourselves busy, keep our minds off of the news for a little bit. The news is so freaking toxic, isn't it? John Lynch says he misses me. I miss you too. I miss you guys a lot. I miss John Lynch and his whole family a lot. Really good people. John, you should pick up your guitar right now, even though I can't hear you. And I want everyone to do something that's creative, either now or after this, because it's really when, like, you feel like you don't have it in you that you need it the most. Like, earlier I was thinking, like, I really should do some live streaming, and now that I've got this Patreon page and everything, and everyone's doing all these, you know, live videos, I'm like, I really should do something, and I totally wasn't in the mood. I was playing with my kids, we were having a picnic. We were at the outside of the beach where there was no one around earlier, doing our social distancing thing, and wasn't in the mood at all. But then, you know, like it is always, once I start drawing, it's like, I don't want to stop. And I know that because it happens every time. I get in these, like, withdrawn, introverted moods. And then I try to convince myself, or my subconscious tries to convince me that, I don't feel like doing art today, not in the mood. And then once I go ahead and do it, and then all of a sudden, hey, look at that. I like doing art, I forgot. Just being honest with you. Don't always do it. But artists have burnout too, right? Oh, John's telling me that he is doing some online lessons with guitar. That's awesome. I just plugged my, just set up my art studio over the past week. We just moved on March 6th, which thankfully we moved in like a week before like all the lockdown stuff happened. And so I had some normalcy, and then it took me until like yesterday to get my guitar amp set up and my, my whole music set up. I want to start getting on that. I plugged in my guitar yesterday and I realized how terrible electric guitar I am. For some reason, acoustic is like so much easier for me than electric. If there's any really good guitar players on here, maybe you could teach me how to play better, because my I just don't seem to do very well with electric guitar, even though I love it. I do love playing it. It's not as forgiving as acoustic in a lot of ways, you know what I mean? And all right, I think I'm gonna throw in some other wave formations in the background here. So if you guys are just joining me, I am using acrylic paint markers, which are UV, what's the word here? Resistant, I guess is the word, and permanent. And they really love getting sucked into this hat. They just like suck right in, which is kind of a pain probably for you to watch me painting over the same lines like 400 times. But you have to kind of build up those layers in order to make it opaque. And as I was saying before, I don't really mind it. It's very cathartic and therapeutic for me. But I don't know for you guys watching if that's like boring or not, but you know, whatever, it's what it is. For any artists watching, I'll do some nerdy art talks. I like nerdy art talk. So whether I'm painting a canvas that is highly refined or whether I'm painting with markers on a hat, my brain sort of uses the same process. As far as compositionally, I'm trying to figure out what lines work, what the layout, composition, and the flow will be. If I was doing this on a canvas, I would obviously build it up a lot more with detail. But as far as the layout goes and the composition, like how my head is thinking it'll work the best, that part of it is still the same. It's still like the same operating system going on, if that makes sense. If you guys hear me banging, I'm using this cardboard here to get the ink flowing, even though it's not ink, the paint. Let's turn around and look at some messages here. John's down for the hat. Cool, John. This is actually a really high quality hat here. I was painting on some old trucker hats earlier, and then and some other hats that I have, but I bought a bunch of blanks of all different colors and stuff to kind of spice things up a bit. And I really loving these hats. Thanks for the jump into a different color, just to give you guys something else to look at, because I feel like it's probably boring looking at the same thing, isn't it? Gonna try throwing in some, I'm gonna throw in some of this, well, you know what? Let me switch it up here. I'm gonna use this lighter color blue, I think. Let's check that out. It's like a lighter version of what I was using. I think that might work okay for like the, for the foam, for the white water. Probably it's not a bad idea to kind of work these things out ahead of time to come up with a sketch and then transfer the sketch onto the hat some way or copy it. I don't really love doing that. I really like the improvisation of just drawing. I love like the looseness of it. And but if this was going on a canvas or a wood panel, if I was about to spend like the next, you know, 3 to 3 weeks to 6 weeks on it, I would definitely have drawn it first. But for a hat, I feel like it really works well with just like this loose flow. Adam DeBunca, where are you from, Adam? He says, do you ever paint lefty just for fun? That's funny you ask that. Yes and no. Sometimes I do. Like if I'm kind of like, sometimes I do just for fun. Sometimes if I'm painting and it's like a very large block of color, like if I was doing the sky or something, or if I was doing some section that's not completely, you know, super crazy detailed, sometimes I'll switch it up and use my left hand just to kind of get my hand used to it. And also just to, just cause it's fun just to be, it feels weird. It's like throwing a ball lefty. It's kind of like your hand is like, what are you doing to me? And I have drawn full pictures lefty, usually when I'm baked or something. I've done that just because it's kind of fun. I don't do it that much though. I don't, because usually I don't draw as well, and I like to draw well because it makes my ego happy if I draw something good, well, good, whatever. I'm not here for grammar, guys. I'm gonna turn this around. I keep forgetting to turn that around for you guys. So right now I'm working in a lighter version of what I had before. And in my head, I'm thinking that there's going to be some sort of a light source here. That doesn't mean that there will be a light source, but in my head, the light source comes from up there. It's sort of vital when you're painting or drawing to either know where the light source is or kind of have an idea of where it should be, because that dictates your shadows, your light, your color of your light, your color of your shadows. Like, it's everything. Unless it's like a completely just a black and white ink drawing, even then a lot of times you need to know where the light source is coming from. But that's one of the most common like amateur art mistakes, I guess, is when you're drawing and you have no idea where the light source is coming from, and you have the shadows going the wrong way, or the color of the light is completely off. It's just like so obvious that the person has no idea what they're doing with their art, which is totally fine. Like, it's nothing wrong with breaking the rules. Just saying, for me, it's just like one of those pet peeves. I'm like, you know what? You know where your light source is, dude. Like, and if you're not an artist, you're like, what the F are you talking about, dude? I get that. Anderson from Brazil. What's up, man? Muito obrigado for joining me. Appreciate that. I love Brazil. I've been there 2 times. I was in Rio, Sao Paulo, and Floripa. And I was there on an art tour both times. It was amazing. The first time was like life-changing. That was in 2007. I did that art tour, and I was one of the only American artists on that tour in Brazil. I was with like my music heroes at the time. It was like Donovan Frankenreiter and G Love and ALO, Matt Costa. And this was like in the prime of like their careers, you know? And that was just amazing. And I'm going to switch this up again and go in with like a lighter blue. I'm deciding between, I think I want to go with it more of a teal. Adam, like, yeah, Adam's referencing what I was talking about, going lefty, like riding switch. Yes, totally. Totally like riding switch. I actually do that. I practice riding switch a lot more than I practice drawing lefty. Ooh, I like that color. That's nice. So yeah, I've been trying to force myself to ride switch on my snowboard pretty often. And it's almost feeling okay for me. Until I overthink it, and then I fall. Like, I'll be going switch the whole way down the mountain, and then I'll be thinking, wow, I'm really getting the hang of this. And then all of a sudden, I just fall on my head. That's kind of why I draw with my left hand sometimes, is to eventually get to the point where I can draw with both hands. I think that would be really fun and cool. And I always play with these, like, warped mental games in my head. Like, what if something, God forbid, happened to my right hand, like what would it be like? And I think maybe I need to practice drawing with my left hand now to redevelop my career. Which reminds me of a story. I was skateboarding, like, this is like a long time ago, after college, and I broke my elbow or finger. I don't know, I've broken a lot of things, but I think I broke my arm or something at the time skating. And I could not play guitar with a broken arm, which really sucked. And so I got a piano keyboard, and I taught myself like piano chords, which was really a good way to, make lemonade out of lemons. Love your questions, guys. I love having you join me. I'm like trying to do this while looking over to see what you guys are saying as much as I can, at least. If you guys are just joining me, I'd love for you to check out my Patreon page while you're watching, because that is my newest idea on how I'm going to get my family through this corona stuff. as far as financially goes, thank God we're healthy. That's all that matters, right? But, you know, the financial stuff is a concern for not just me, but other artists, musicians, and freelancers of all sorts. So if there are any freelance people, or artists that you love, whether it's me or someone else, like try to do something to help them out. So I created this Patreon page. Check it out. I'd love to know what you think about the tiers that I set up. Basically, have to set up these levels of, you know, if you give me $2, you get this, $5, get that, one of those sort of things. Let me get on the iPhone here. Drifted off of my head and I forgot I'm videotaping. So I have to make sure I keep in sight of the camera, don't I? Hey, Grace. Hey, Gianna. My two friends. I don't know if you guys even know each other, but you're both in Point Pleasant. So I'm liking these markers, but they really suck into this material like so fast. I might have to keep searching for another brand because I sort of have to go over this like over and over and over to get the any kind of opacity built up. Here's what I got so far. Thinking I might throw in some purple here next. What do you guys think? Are you guys fans of purple? What's up, Gianna? I got a little nice message on my Facebook from Gianna. This is my first like live stream. That's sort of my first attempt at like being proper about it. Like sometimes I will have Chelsea hold my iPhone while I'm painting, or like I'll stick the iPhone on something while I'm doing something. But I got this more professional-ish setup. Not really professional, but more professional. And trying to figure out which service to use for streaming, and it's been a lot to try to figure out the ins and outs of everything. I'd imagine watching someone tattoo is probably this slow and tedious because you're working with a needle, so I shouldn't complain about drawing with a fine tip marker. Because I'd imagine tattooing is a lot more tedious and bloody, for that matter. Let's see. Pretty cool so far. Adam Tabanka, you heard the Bad Wolf zombie cover? No, I am actually admittedly in like a bubble when it comes to music, especially since like my kids were born. I've been like really horrible at knowing bands that are not in my normal playlist. I used to be really good about that. I used to know like everyone who's everyone. Nowadays, meaning like the past like 6.5 years since I became a dad, I don't know any bands that are outside of my normal listening. So I don't know the Bad Wolves, but I didn't know my music was playing loud enough for you guys to hear, so that's cool. I have got Zombie playing in the background, but I'll have to check out that cover. That's Sarah Downey. What's up? It's great to see familiar names and faces pop up on here. I hope over the next week or so I can get the live streaming thing more like refined and centralized. But not bad for a first whack at it. Let's see. I want to keep in a lot of the negative space of like the dark hat color, but I also want to maintain this teal like throughout the flow of the light. So if the light's coming in that direction, I want to make sure that this teal color is following through. Otherwise it'll look bizarre to have like the teal and all of a sudden it just stops. So if you see me stopping my marker for a while, I'm just sort of improvising as I go, and I'm trying to figure out all the colors. But yeah, there we go. It's coming out pretty cool so far, I think. Guys, throw some comments on my Facebook if you want. I'll be checking them out as I go, and I love having a little cyber company as much as anyone does. I wonder if any of you guys watched that live stream with Dave Matthews yesterday. I watched it last night until my kids came in the room and they wanted to watch Once Upon a Time. And we changed it, but I caught most of it. It's like that broadcast with Dave Matthews from his house, and he's like one of my absolute favorite musicians in the planet Earth. And Rage Against the Machine just came on. That's pretty rad. Another one of my favorites. I'm going to switch up to purple, I think. I think I'm feeling some purple. Let me see if this is even... see if that's even light enough to show up. Let's see. We'll find out soon enough, right? Let me see. Ah, I think that's too dark. Let's try this. All right, I'm going to give this color a whack. It's kind of like a pinkish purple color. Thanks, John. John says it's looking good, my man. Appreciate that, dude. Totally appreciate that, man. Dude, Rage Against the Machine is so good. Is anyone else as across the board with their music as I am? Like, I completely can go from like Dave Matthews to like Rage to System of a Down to Sinatra. I think it's good to be eclectic, isn't it? I think so. These markers really don't like this hat very much. They just suck right in like a sponge. It's working fine. I just have to go over the lines a few times. Is everyone feeling good? I'm wondering if anyone has any relatives or friends or anything that's dealing directly with the coronavirus. Hope you guys are all healthy, feeling good. It's easy to forget that a lot of people are really, really suffering right now. Really scary stuff. I'm gonna pick out a white color, whitish. See if I even have a white color. Do I have one? Must have a white color. Let's see. There we go. And I think I need some. There we go. Nice juicy white color right there. Adam Sirota just joined me. What's up, Adam? I didn't scroll down to see the new comments. I see a bunch of you guys saying some nice stuff on there. Tony Cullinan. How do I say your name? Cullinan? Cullinan. I don't know how to say it. I always see your name on my social media, and I should know how to say your name by now. Sent you some Captain Good Vibes art pics from an old 70s record I took a few weeks ago. Nice place to hear you chatting along. Thank you. That's really cool of you. Sort of like just blabbing. So hopefully you guys don't mind me talking while I'm doing this. I guess I need socialization of some sort more than I realized. So if any artists are watching, I'll try to throw in some art nerd stuff for you. Actually, which brings me back to my Patreon. I just did a few posts on one of my paintings. I've been sort of like dissecting my art to teach kind of about the process of my work a little bit on my Patreon page. But anyway, so I'm putting in some lights now. I usually work dark to light, usually. There's never really like one way to paint or draw, but that's usually what I do. So I'm getting to the highlights a little bit. And I think when I do highlights, especially, I have to really zone out because I'm trying to think too much. It's not going to work. When I'm painting, I try to like pretend that I sort of am. This is going to sound weird. I try to pretend that I sort of am the light. Like I think if I was a wave or a particle of light, where would I be going? Where would I be traveling to? What would I be bouncing off of? I sort of connect on like a spiritual level to the water, whether I'm surfing or just looking at the water. And I don't know if you guys can relate to this, but I sort of just really become one with it. And I imagine I kind of just try to see it there before I even draw it. It's not like I'm thinking in a analytical way, like, oh, the light must hit this way and the refraction must go that way. I just sort of zoning out and letting it happen. So what I think I'm going to do is put some foam, some white water here to kind of balance out the composition a little bit. And yeah, let's do that. If you guys are liking what I'm doing, or if you don't like what I'm doing, that's fine too. Love to hear your comments though, or suggestions. I prefer compliments over not compliments, but as an artist, you have to be able to take it all, right? But I get it. Either way, it's cool. But I'm going to be doing more live feeds like this, along with like actual paintings, like real paintings. And I'll be doing that on my Patreon page. If you're interested in such things, me blabbing away while I'm actually painting, or just being a weird artistic voyeur and watching me do my thing. Gonna be doing this a lot more. Just check out patreon.com/jalders. That's my infomercial right there. Sorry to be all like commercially with you, but you know, got three kids I gotta feed, so it's okay to be real, right? I'm not Banksy. Gotta actually promote yourself if you're a creative person. I don't think sales and marketing and trying to support your family is selling out, although I hear a lot of artists worry about that, which I can kind of understand. Like, it feels icky to have to deal with those sort of things, but I think there's creativity in all of it, and unless you are like a Shepard Fairey or Banksy kind of guy, even Shepard Fairey is kind of quite a salesman, so I shouldn't say that. It's very few people that can play the Picasso role and just paint and not have to deal with the salesman part of it and the hustle part of it. It's not as romantic always, is it? But it's the truth. Sarah Downey saying, loving this. Thank you. It's very sweet of you. I really, 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 really appreciate that. I hope you don't mind how many times I have to kind of keep going over the same lines, but like sucks in and then I have to wait for it to dry and then I have to go over it again. It's like a tattoo. Let's think of it as a tattoo. Then I'll stop feeling guilty about not being entertaining enough. So far, none of you guys are taking my bait to tell me how you're doing. Hopefully that's a good sign. I really want to know how you're doing, guys, during the lockdown. Is it easy for you? Is it hard? Are you sick? Are you healthy? So
wish I was charismatic as Bob Ross, man. I used to watch him when I was a kid, like for hours. I need some kind of cool catchphrases like happy little trees, happy little waves. So if you do these kinds of hats at home, it's not a terrible idea to use a dryer. I have like this cool handheld dryer that I use sometimes when I'm doing stuff. And speeds up the process, but I'm not really in a rush right now at all. Although my wife's going to tell me dinner is ready soon, so I guess I should be rushing more. But whatever, it's cool. Man, whatever happened to this band? Can you guys give me some, for those of you that I don't know, can you give me some shout outs if you haven't already on my Facebook page, like comments? I'd love to know where you're from, what you're up to, that sort of thing. Also, suggestions, if you guys want to see me paint something else, whether it's a certain kind of subject matter or whether it's like, I want you to paint women's socks or something. I don't know, whatever. If you have a thing, that's your thing. That's not my thing. I'll give you a for instance. I had this really nice lady message me on my, on Facebook, actually. And she saw some of the posts that I was doing of my kids and I painting. And she commissioned us meaning me and my children, to paint her four cats. Which at first I was like, you want myself and my kids to paint you a picture? But then I was like, how freaking cool is that? That my kids are getting their first like art commission. And how cool would that be to do that? So I'm actually, it went from being a very strange request to like, I'm really actually quite excited about it. My kids are keep asking me every day, like, do we get to start the painting of that lady's cats? Sarah Downey just says she painted a phoenix. Awesome. It's really, really important to stay creative when there's stressful times. I do it all the time, like as far as forgetting that it's important to paint or draw. I wish I could tell you that I painted and drew every day in like another version of reality. I wish that was true, but I don't. I'm just so busy, as you know, being a dad and with work stuff and just life. That a lot of times I deprioritize it, and I wish that wasn't true. Because it's like every time I get back to it, I realize how important it is. I'm gonna go back to the other teal color and a lighter teal, and I'm gonna start throwing in some second layers on this to build up the opacity, because it really gets sucked in, and acrylic paints in general dry darker. Oil paints usually dry a little bit lighter until you re-oil them the next day. They'll dry and have a little bit of a haze, whereas oil paints will generally dry darker. I wish that wasn't true. It's one of the things about acrylics that I can't stand, but it is true. You'll paint it light, and all of a sudden, next thing you know, it's darker, and you're like, what the hell? You know what? I wish I was a rock star. I'm listening to these bands, and I'm like, that's what I wish I was able to do. I think if I was a rock star, I would just sing everything instead of talk. I like that. Gotta stay on camera here, Jay. Jay, stay on the camera and stop going off camera. Adjust this a little bit. If this clamp falls off, I'm gonna have to readjust, but let's see how I do. Let's see if there's any new comments on here. No new comments. No. Anyone still online watching? Did I lose you all? It's okay. Don't think I did, but if I did, that's okay too. All right, I'm gonna switch it up again. I think I'm gonna do some more white. God, Nirvana was so good, huh? Needs purple. I'm not sure where. Let's see. See here. Let's see. Oh, we got a comment from Sarah. Thank you. So it's looking very good. Thank you. I appreciate that. What kind of markers? I actually put the link to these markers on, where did I put them? On my website, because I figured someone might ask that. And I know if it was me watching, I would want to know. So I'm trying to think of the website, or the, not the website, or the URL. I think it's jalders.com/resources. Check that out. Look under acrylic painting. I think I threw the link on there. So yeah, I'm pretty sure it's jalders.com/resources, I think, is the link if you want to look at these exact markers. They're my overall review. This is my first time using them, so I'll give you an honest review. I think they're I love how like sharp the points are. And I love the variety pack of colors that they come in. But one of the limitations is just how if you're painting on a hat, at least. This is wouldn't be the same if you're painting on something else, but when you're painting on a hat, it sucks in like so much. I tried these on paper before and it was totally different experience. But overall, I really like them. Just the medium itself is like, it's really absorbing into the fabric, which is you know, it's kind of to be expected. But I was, I was using these markers on paper and I really love how they maintain the point. Because what's one of my biggest like pet peeves about paint markers is usually the points aren't that good, which is fine if you're painting big, but when you're painting detail stuff, I really like having like that point. I think I also put the link for these markers on my Amazon page, which I honestly don't remember the link. I'll have to post it later. Oh, and she also asked, she being Sarah asked, are you going to sell it? Yes. I am an artist dealing with the economy as much as anyone else is. So yes, I totally will be selling this. I just wanted to share the process with you guys a little bit. Keep myself from going crazy and maybe give you guys something fun to watch in the background or whatever else you're doing. Fully acknowledge this would be more interesting to watch. Maybe time lapsed or something, but it's also kind of cool to watch it happen as it happens, isn't it? And I'm kind of feeling this purple. I kind of like that purple. What do you guys think? You see it okay? I'm gonna move this phone back a little bit so you can see better. Is that better? Oh man, REM. Freaking love REM. You are not me. Saw them only one time in concert, but it was awesome. better than them drying out too fast. The more, oh yeah, that's totally true. I can't stand when markers dry out too fast either. I was making my own markers for a bit. I still do. I have these. You can buy like empty shells of markers and just add fluid acrylic to it. We got Alexander on my other feed saying this is pretty cool. Thank you. Really appreciate that. I love your comments, everyone. I love knowing where you're from, what you're doing. Yeah. Sorry, I'm like reading comments as I'm painting, as I'm listening to music, as I'm thinking. Not the greatest multitasker in the world. Hey, whisper. Got to recenter this here. Got to move the camera around a little bit. Let's see. Let's see if that's better. You, like a hurt, lost, and blinded fool. Oh. Yes, I sing to myself quite a bit. You guys only saw me painting like for real, like real painting. Sing to myself, do crazy dances. Sing like no one's listening and dance like no one's watching, right? Which is part of the reason I like isolation. I get to be as weird as I want. Of course, that's weird to say as I'm broadcasting a live feed with me singing. Well, there we go. Centered. Alexander, where are you from, Alexander? Is asking, are you going to add a surfer to it? Not in this particular one. I'm not going to add a surfer. I was thinking about doing that, but since this is like the first time that I'm painting with these markers on this material, I didn't want to get too complex, even though I sort of am anyway. My intention was not to get too complex. And I didn't want to have to do anything that would take like a sketch before doing it. I'm sort of ad-libbing it, and you could do that a lot easier when it's like organic elements like a wave or clouds or nature. I just didn't feel like it needed a surfer. I wanted to make it more more oceany and wavy, and didn't think that was necessary for this particular one. But I probably will do something like that for another one. I got a bunch of blank hats. So let's see. So I'm thinking, I don't know if I should add some stuff going on here. I think I'm gonna add some blue. Let's see if I can get a nice blue going on. Just a dream. Let's see, the color would look good here. Green might look cool. Nah, not green. Let's see. Colorado. I love Colorado, man. I'm a huge, huge fan of Colorado. It's like one of my, one of the states I would totally live in if I was to move. Of course, I've not been to like enough places to say where the perfect place is, but of the places I've been in my country, at least, Colorado is definitely one of my favorites. Metallica, old school Metallica is so good, right? Who's with me on that? Everyone, of course everyone's with me on that. The dumb question, Jay. All right, I'm getting close to the end. Getting close to the end here. Just sort of like reinforcing some of the lines, bringing out some more of the opacity. Really want this to pop a little more, so I really have to go over it a few times to do that. I'm also going to like reinforce some of like the connections between the colors. So is the one. Don't forget my son. Metallica is like one of those musical groups that I like love so much. Their lyrics hit me differently now that I'm a dad and now that I'm old. I feel like Eminem is another one. I love Eminem, but as I've gotten older, I'm not as down for his lyrics as I used to be. I know I sound old saying that. That's okay. Still love him. All right, we get some more white again. Get some more highlights, and then I'm getting close to being done. This is gray. Oh, where the heck my white went? Oh, here it is. My white is on my desk. So the final phases of these sorts of things is when you add the highlights and the details. That's like when everything just pops. A lot of times a painting can look kind of like so-so up until the very, very end. And you like have to have patience just to know, and faith to know, that at the end is when it comes together. I haven't mentioned it in a while, so I'm going to throw my infomercial out there again. I'm going to be doing a lot more of these live feeds, and I'm saving them, or a lot of them at least, for my Patreon page. Since it's a new one, I just set it up like a day ago. I didn't want to exclude everyone else. But I will be doing a lot more of these things on my Patreon page, and I would love for you guys to consider throwing me some love on that page. Patreon.com/JAlders. If you have like a few moments to check it out, if you have any questions, let me know. That's my infomercial for you. Hope you don't mind. And I think I'm going to throw in some highlights down here, make sure you guys can see it. And then probably wrap this one up so I can go eat some dinner. So I am using acrylic paints. Paint markers are UV resistant, fade resistant, permanent, etc. All good qualities you want when you're wearing a hat, right? All right, I'm putting in the highlights now, and the this is definitely like the icing on the cake sort of phase. One of my favorite parts of paintings is when the painting finally starts to come together and like just starts to pop. And these are like the moments that I'm grateful that I had patience to wait until the end, because it's hard as an artist to like wait for the painting or a drawing to really work. You want to just, a lot of us by human nature just want to hurry up and get done with it. But I find that if you're patient enough to wait to do things in the right order, it pays off. It's usually worth it. It's worth the wait. So I don't know if you can see on there or not, but it is really kind of pulling it together by adding the highlights. A few of you guys are asking if I'm selling it. Yes, I am selling it. I don't know where yet. I'll probably put it on my website. I will offer it to my patrons first because I told them I would. Got to be fair. But if they do not want it, then I will. You guys are welcome to message me, or I'll put it on my website. I'm really digging that. I got a little creating like a little bevel type effect, a little highlight going on. Really, really digging that. Hopefully you guys can see what I'm talking about so I don't sound like I'm reacting over nothing, but kind of creating some sort of a, almost like a, not 3D, but kind of like a graphic-y, graffiti-ish type thing going on here with the different levels of color, kind of building up form and structure. Can you guys see that? I don't know if you can. Kind of digging that. Doesn't matter if it's like a hat or a painting, it's all gratifying for me. Oh yeah, it's looking good. Wash away the rain. Just gonna throw in some other stuff here. Let's see here. It's like a dark. Throwing in like a little bit of a lighter version of the kind of gray that's here already to bring in some ambient light. Kind of make it pop a little more, and it kind of unifies, sort of unifies everything. Close. You guys don't mind how long I'm taking. I'm just sort of, I have no reason to rush, so I'm just putting extra effort into it. Just because I can, why not, right? Oops, should be on camera, shouldn't I? God, I keep forgetting the camera's not on the thing. Sorry, I'm like painting and I look over and it's like, oh yeah, camera's not even on. Gotta move up the camera a little bit here so you. So a better view. Is that better? Do-do-do-do-do. So, just to say it again, I hope you guys are doing good. I hope everyone's feeling okay. Really scary times. I felt like a really crazy parent before because we were out in public and I was, you know, telling my kids not to touch anything and like, no, don't touch this, don't touch that. And every time a person came by, I'm like, you know, don't go near them, stay away. And I'm like, and then they started like running towards like, the, you know, this big grassy field that was full of all these wet leaves and stuff. And if anyone is you know, if anyone has Lyme's or knows about it, I'm like just terrified about Lyme's disease, which is like a tick-borne illness. So here I am yelling about keeping my kids safe from coronavirus while I'm yelling at them to stay away from the trees and the grass because I don't want them to, they don't have bug spray on and I don't want them to get Lyme's disease. And I'm like, Jesus Christ, like what kind of freaking parent am I? Definitely not the world I grew up in. It's hard to kind of balance that protectionism and not making them paranoid while keeping them safe. You know, it's, I don't know. It's really weird. Weird times. Anyway, Blink-182 was great, huh? So I'm getting close to being done. I'm just really trying to bring out some of the highlights more. It's just gets sucked into the hat, and I have to go over it a bunch of times in order for it to show, which I don't really mind. But I realize it might not be fun to watch. Maybe it is. I don't know. I think it's coming out pretty cool, though. I just looked over, and Michelle Farfel and Kim Larson joined. Oh, my God. My Montessori peeps. You guys are welcome to comment. I'd love to talk to you while I'm doing this. Need like a camera, like a camera director, whatever they called. I don't know. Someone to keep me like focused on making sure the hat is in the frame of the video. Keep looking over and I'm like pointing the video at nothing. Alright, so I'm almost done. I'm trying to think what else I want to do here. I feel like it needs some blue, and I'm trying to figure out where, and I think I just figured out where the blue needs to go, I think. I think the blue needs to go here. In case you haven't noticed from my process here, I'm completely ad-libbing. I have no idea, like, what's going to happen next any more than you do. I have, like, no sketch at all. It's like an art jam. I really, really, really like painting and drawing with no plan. I don't often get to do it. If I'm doing like a commission piece or if I'm doing like an actual painting, I always have like a plan and a blueprint and ideas. And it's not as loose when you do that, but it's necessary. And so I like just kind of like just goofing around and just painting. Seriously, how good is this song, huh? I'm gonna sound old. They just don't make music like this anymore, do they? Really, 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 really tried to like Billie Eilish because my nieces love her. And I wanted to feel like I was hip and cool. So I spent a couple of hours, no, not that long, maybe an hour, listening to her music. I don't get it. I don't know. Super talented. Way better than I am at music. For sure. Can't. God, I wish I could sing, so I'd love to sing to you guys. For those of you that can sing, sort of hate you. Kidding. You know who I hate though is when you people that can sing that don't sing. Like they don't show off their talent. But you can sing, but you don't do it a lot. Like really? Come on. What do you guys think so far? Coming out cool? into it, feeling it, hate it. Really like that blue, man. Are you with me on that? Truthfully, tell me. You into it? I like it. God, I wish I could keep the color before it sucks in. It's like so nice and vivid, and then it's like sucks right in. I have to keep going over and over. Watch, ready? There it is. Boom. It would be cool to like ad lib like this with a tattoo. I don't know who would let me do that, but that would be fun. Another good song. It's like Spotify seriously kills the playlists, don't they? Sorry guys, you get to hear me sing. I know it's awful, but it's the price you pay. There was like a button on the Facebook thing, whatever, that like let you guys zap me whenever I take the hat out of the frame of the video. You can like hit a button and it zaps me to let me know that it's not in frame. I think I'm getting close to being done. I know I keep saying that, but it's hard to stop. It's really hard to stop sometimes. All right. I'm going to give myself 2 minutes to finish. Otherwise, I will end up doing this for another hour if I don't stop myself. You guys are just joining me. Make sure you Stay inside, stay safe. And if you're bored, check out my Patreon page. This is my latest scheme on how to make sure I'm taking care of my family during the economy taking a nosedive. And I will keep doing cool things like this for you, I promise. For those of you that have already supported me on there, thank you so much. Really appreciate it. I'm gonna wrap up, I think. Probably like have added a few more rounds with the highlights just to make it pop, but I feel like I'm dragging this on for you and I don't want to do that. Give you guys some closure here. So what do you think? Thanks for joining me, everyone. Appreciate it a lot. Let me see if I can hit the button and end this sucker. Da-na.